In this video, what I want to show you is how to create a data set in SPSS and how to define a set of variables. So after you install SPSS, you probably have an icon like this on your desktop. If you click on it, then SPSS opens and you see a window that looks like this. SPSS asks you whether you want to open an existing data source, whether it is an SPSS data or a data from a different software. I do not want any of these options right now, so I'm just going to cancel this. What I want to show you is how to create your own data set. So you see two tabs here, one that is called Data View and the other one is called the Variable View. Now in the Data View, we actually see the data or the numbers that go into the data. In the Variable View, we are going to see a list of variables that we have in the data set. So I'm going to start with the Variable View. What I had in mind is to create a list of students and then record their gender and their IQ. So my first variable is going to be name. In the column type here, I am going to choose, instead of numeric, I'm going to choose string, which means that the variable will consist of characters, not of numbers. In this column, I can set up the length of the variable. So 8 is probably not enough for a name, so I'm just going to increase this, say, to 20. Now, obviously, I'm not going to need any decimals for name, and label is just a place where you can write a more explicit label for your variable. So I could say student name. And then here in the measure column, I need to specify the type of variable that I'm working with, whether it is ordinal or nominal. Obviously, name is a nominal variable, so I'm not going to change this. My next variable is going to be ID. Just for the sake of confidentiality and also for practical reasons, the statisticians don't actually work with names. They work with numbers or IDs instead of names. Several people may have the same name, or the names may be misspelled from the person who's entering the data in the computer. So we work with IDs. IDs are going to be numeric. Let's say the width can be just 2 for our data set, and we don't need any decimals for the ID. In the label, I can just say student ID. And the variable type is also going to be nominal, because even though we're working with numbers, their meaning is nominal. Another variable that I would like to add to my list is gender. Gender is also going to be a numeric variable. Even though we actually know it's a categorical variable, we are going to use numbers to code males and females. Now the width for gender does need to be 8, because we're just going to use the numbers 0 and 1, so the width is actually 1. And of course, we do not need any decimals. For the label, we could just say student gender. Now here in this column, we can specify the values. For the other two variables, we didn't need to do that because there are many possible values. We cannot specify all the possible names, for instance. But for gender, we can specify how we are going to code the two categories. So we are going to have 0 for males, and click add here, and 1 for females. And this is just to help us remember how we coded the variable later on when we want to use the data set again. So I'm going to click again, and we can see that we have these two values here. At the variable type, we have to specify that this is a nominal variable. Again, we have categories, we cannot order them, so it's a nominal variable. The fourth variable that I want to have is IQ. IQ is also going to be numeric. We're going to use numbers, obviously, for IQs. Now, the width is going to be 3, because we use up to three digits for IQs. We don't have any decimals, so the decimals are going to be 0. We can label it student IQ. Again, we're not going to specify all the possible values. And here, at the variable type, or the measure, we have to specify scale, because this variable is on a ratio scale. Remember, it's a quantitative variable. So these are the four variables that I want to have in my data set. So now I can go to data view and start entering the data. So in this first column, I'm going to start entering names. For instance, I could say John, Mary, Linda, Jose, Steve, and so forth. For IDs, I'm just going to assign integers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Now, for gender, remember we coded this variable, so we're going to do zeros for males and 1 for females. 1, 0, 0. And IQs, I'm just going to enter some random numbers here. Say 120, 100, 98, 81, and 99. Now, for some of these values, we may not have the information. For instance, let's say that Linda didn't specify her gender. So, even though she's obviously a female, we cannot assume that, so we're going to have a missing value here. So this is what our data set is going to look like, and I'm just going to add some more observations so we can conduct some statistical analysis.